up, y'all? Welcome back to Zeta TV.
I got loyalty, got royalty inside my DNA. Quarter piece, got war and peace inside my DNA.
It is Wednesday, and you know what time it is. It is Powerful Woman Wednesday, part one.
Y'all excuse me if I sound a little stuffy. I'm not feeling my best. But we're going to make it do what it do.
All right, first up, we have our honorable mention for today. And it is my soror, Barbara Charlene Jordan. Soror Jordan was born February 21st, 1936 in Houston, Texas. She was an American lawyer, educator, and a politician who was also a leader of the civil rights movement. She attended Texas Southern University, where she pledged the Delta Gamma chapter of Delta Sigma Theta Sorority, Incorporated. She attended Boston University School of Law, graduating in 1959. She was the first African American elected to the Texas Senate after Reconstruction. She was also the first Southern African American woman to be elected in the United States House of Representatives. She was best known for her eloquent opening statement at the House of the Judiciary Committee during the process of impeachment for Richard Nixon. And as the first African American, as well as the first woman to deliver the keynote address at the Democratic National Convention, she received the Presidential Medal of Freedom amongst numerous other honors. She was also the first African American woman to be buried in the Texas State Cemetery. Thank you, Soror Jordan, for being that torch of wisdom the United States needed. All right, moving on to our next highlighted African American woman of history for today. Next, we have Gwendolyn Elizabeth Brooks. Born in 1917, she was an American poet, an author, and also a teacher. Majority of her work often dealt with the personal celebrations and struggles of the ordinary people in her community. Gwendolyn Brooks was the first African American to receive the Pulitzer Prize on May 1st of 1950 for her most famous work, Annie Allen.
Throughout her prolific writing career, Brooks received many more honors.
A lifelong resident of Chicago, she was appointed Poet Laureate of Illinois in 1968, a position she held until her death 32 years later. She was also named the Poet Laureate Consultant in the Poetry of the Library of Congress for the year of 1985 to 1986 term. In 1976, she became the first African-American woman inducted into the American Academy of Arts and Letters.
Thank you, Gwendolyn Elizabeth Brooks.
And this concludes Powerful Woman Wednesday. I hope you guys got some great information out of this video. I hope you guys can take away something from this video and apply it to your life. The amount of boldness that these women had to achieve the many different awards that they've achieved, the many different things that they've achieved as African American women, use that as fuel. All right, you guys, be sure to like, comment, and subscribe to the channel if you are new to my channel. Be sure to check back in on Monday for Manhood Monday, part two. Thank you guys for watching.
I got loyalty inside my DNA. Quarter piece, got war and peace inside my DNA. I got power, poison, pain, and joy.